But now we are in trouble. Yeah, we are in a big trouble, you know? Because we just defined like tz through the Cauchy integral formula, but we also had another definition of the semigroup, which goes back to the Hille-Yoshida's theorem, where this was the limit of the negative exponential sequence. Right, the limit n to infinity I minus t over n a to the minus n. This is how we originally defined the semigroup e to the at. And now we come with the Cauchy integral formula. So is this the same? Or are these the same at least if they have real arguments? So that's an important question. And the answer is the next theorem. They are the same. So let tz be the analytical semigroup defined by 820, meaning the Cauchy integral formula. Then the sectorial operator which appears in this formula, ADA, is the generator. So meaning if you do the Hille-Yoshida thing to that Cauchy integral formula, you get the same A. This is something we need to prove. This is not immediately clear. So let's assume tz is defined through A20 and has a generator B. Let's call it just B for now and then show A is B. Instead of showing A is B, we show that the resolvents are the same. R lambda B is equal to R lambda A for one lambda. We just show this for a particular lambda in the resolvent set. Because if R lambda A is R lambda B, then A minus lambda I is equal to B minus lambda I, and this implies A is B. So we need to show identity of the resolvent operators for one particular lambda. And the lambda we had chosen is omega plus 2, where omega is the growth rate of the semigroup TT, and 2 is 2. Okay, again we use the Laplace transform formula for the B resolvent here. And again we use a specific path gamma 1 with radius R is 1, the same as we had before. So, but then the figure I'm plotting is a little bit different because now this would be gamma 1 again. I close it the other way around because here is a point lambda which is omega plus 2 and I want to include this lambda in there. If I do this though, then the orientation of the curve is clockwise. So this is mathematically a negative orientation which gives us then a minus sign. Okay, but do this slowly. So we start with the formula for the resolvent involving the semigroup, and then I replace the semigroup with the Cauchy integral formula right here. And this involves a time integration, and this is an integral I can do because the time only arises in the exponents, e to the minus lambda t, e to the mu t. So this can be integrated, and it gives me this bit here from the time integration, and then the resolvent stays. Okay, and now I'm doing this path integral with gamma 1, where I go clockwise. And then for the one term here, I'm integrating over the pole at omega plus 2. So then I just get the resolvent at lambda. In the other case, I keep the integral. So is this right here? Let's see. There it is. So this term here correspond to the 1 in the numerator, and then the other term here corresponds to the exponential, so I just keep it the way it is. Now the last term can be estimated. Here it is again. E to the minus t0, mu minus lambda, so lambda is bigger than mu, so this has a negative exponent, and that's important. This is how I have chosen the lambda, so that I can get a negative exponent there. The norm of x, the resolvent is estimated by this m epsilon divided by mu, and then the mu minus lambda is here. And again, mu minus lambda is bounded by 1, so this is also not 0. Okay, so in this estimate here, this is which tells me how I have to choose lambda to make everything work. But then it does work. So now I can send t to infinity, this guy, and everything goes to zero. Meaning I keep only the first bit, the r lambda a, and the resolvents are the same. which means the operators are the same, and I'm done. Whew, so we are lucky, we are not in trouble. Right? I mean, it doesn't make sense to have two definitions for one semigroup unless they're really the same, and they are. So here, just a quick example. Again, the heat equation semigroup with homogeneous Dirichlet boundary conditions, second derivative, homogeneous boundary conditions, because here we can explicitly compute the spectrum, C, because the spectral values are all eigenvalues and there are minus n square pi square over L square. So there's here and here and here and here and so on. These are the lambda n. So the spectrum is clearly on the left, and we can happily find a sector with an angle pi half plus delta. So maybe this one, sector pi half plus delta. So we get analytic semigroup. In fact, it would be sectorial for any angle between 0 and pi over 2. So then e to the t d by dx square is an analytic semigroup in the sector sigma delta around the positive axis. So that's quite powerful, right? The theory is powerful. So here I needed like 5 lines to show that the heat equation is analytic. Then here is a comment which I do without proof, theorem 884. If A generates an analytic semigroup, then A is sectorial. Okay, so the generators of analytic semigroups have automatically the property to be sectorial. So we can find a sector which divides the spectrum from the resolvent set.